Hello all. Alright, the new lighting system is up and running. Looks a little better. But I still think we have problems with the camera. Possibly some pixels or something went out in the sensor, making it look so red. But that's not what I'm here to talk about today. So, I had somebody talk to me the other day, very concerned about hurricanes and how big they were going to get and how powerful and how they might someday wipe out an entire continent with one storm. Well, it doesn't quite work that way. Let's go over to the board and I'll show you what I mean. Yeah, now I'm pretty sure that the camera's messed up because you can't see this hardly. But what it says is strongest hurricanes 2019 is, well, in 2019 so far it's this one. Lorenzo is a 145 mile an hour hurricane or 233.355 kph. In 2019, it's in the Atlantic Ocean, and it's the strongest one in that particular position in the Atlantic. They've never had one so far east so powerful. The strongest recorded ever hurricane is Patrika at 215 miles an hour, or 346.009 kph in 2015. But what we're going to do is look down here. This is planet Earth, and this is how come hurricanes can't get much bigger than this. Is because as a hurricane grows, you see, the problem is that the width of the hurricane. So this wind is spinning as fast as it can, depending on where you are in the hurricane. So let's put the hurricane on the globe. So let's say that we have one this big. Well, as you can see, that won't happen because of the curvature of the Earth. Now, the flat earthers, they can have any size hurricane they want because the surface is flat. So a hurricane on planet Earth has to actually bend with the Earth. And that bending of the hurricane, this is extreme, causes friction with the wind hitting the planet so that the wind can't really get any higher. And the more curved it gets, the more the hurricane wants to shred apart, break apart. So this is about the biggest hurricane you're ever going to see, even in super climate change, when we get really high in temperatures and things. Hurricane, the only change will be that there'll be far more hurricanes and they'll be all big ones. So that if this is the U.S. and a Category 5, which is probably about this big, it's about as big as they get, was to slam into Florida, you know, you might take out most of the state of Florida and possibly Alabama and Georgia and a little bit of South Carolina, but you're never going to take out a continent. It's physically impossible because of the curvature of the Earth. It puts the brakes on storms. That's why storms only get so big. So many times we've talked about how climate change will look. It will look a lot like it does today, except that the hurricanes, instead of threes and twos, which will still be around, but you'll be up into the fives more regularly than twos and threes, and the destruction will be massive. But it won't take out a continent, unless you're a little island nation. Now, island nations in the Atlantic, near the U.S., the equator, are going to have to find other places to live, or live in concrete bunkers of some sort, because these islands will get hit over and over again, and sooner or later they'll just wear down to where there isn't any island there at all. The waves and the erosion will be so severe. not mentioning sea level rise. But hurricanes will also be going further north and further south than they are today as the climate warms and the ocean warms. Now by 2100, they're saying the oceans could warm as high as 9 degrees Fahrenheit above where they are today by 2100. It's a lot of water to heat up, and all that ice in the Greenland and Antarctica, all that is going to cool down water. So that's why they're saying it's going to take 100 years to get water temperatures in the ocean to 9 or 10 degrees higher than they are today. 1 or 2 degrees is going to make a huge difference with the world weather pattern. You're going to increase moisture in the atmosphere, making these big storms more frequent, causing more damage. Humans are going to have to rebuild everything because it's just too weak for what's coming. You know what I mean? Yeah, I'm afraid our camera must have a pixel out. So, I definitely appreciate all the comments on the last videos. The ups and the downs, and if you want to try a subscription, go for it. And until next time.